The most crowded quarterback room in college football and complete position breakdowns on TCU right here at Mark Rogers TV, the voice of college football. Mark Rogers TV, the voice of college football, breaking it down with Billy Wessels. We're looking at TCU position by position. Grab the Amazon link in the description below. It helps us build the channel and keeps the content coming your way. All right, at wide receiver, everybody knows about Jalen Reagor coming off a nice season despite the upheaval at quarterback in the marginal play, 72 catches, 9 touchdowns. This Tay Barber's a kid that, despite being a true freshman, was consistent in playing every game, catching a pass every week out. I'm concerned about the 9.5 yards per catch. Is that more a product of the quarterback play or just not that type of receiver to get downfield?
Oh, he's a little guy. He's a little slot receiver, 5'9", listed. I'm looking at he's listed at 186. I'll take the under on that as far as weight goes. He's like a thicker Kevontae Turpin, if you remember watching him play when he was here. But Turpin could go a little bit deeper. Barber's going to be a hands guy. Just going to compare him like to Wes Welker for people that don't necessarily watch him. Guys that can sure hands, going to get you a chunk of yards and could bust it open if he needs to, but that's not really his game. Jalen Reagor is the big play threat. He's the guy everyone needs to watch out for. He put TCU on his back those last 3 weeks of the season, basically carried them to wins against Baylor and Oklahoma State by getting like a rushing and a receiving touchdown in each of the last two games. So he's been incredible. I saw an early mock draft had him going number 13 this year, which I think is a little high. But he's going to be awfully impressive. So now you've got those two that you can count on. What else do you have? Looking at the depth chart that just came out like 2 weeks ago, Trey Heights is listed as a starter, 6'3", 185, big target. But like 4 of his 6 catches are for 47-yard touchdowns. I can't make that up. He is just a deep threat. So if you go back to TCU in 2014, they had a guy like that and Colby Listenby, a guy that could just fly down the field and catch a deep pass. That's probably looking at Trey Heights. Reagor can do it all. Barber's your slot guy that can make a big catch when needed to. Maybe Heights is your speed guy, and you need someone else to be another option. You need John Stevens or DeValence Hunt or Darius Davis to step up and become a guy that you can count on for catches when Jalen Reagor gets double covered. Who can you rely on? So I think it's a really interesting position this year because there's a lot of talk, and weirdly enough, I'm hearing this mostly from UT fans, that says Gary Patterson has said they're changing the offense up entirely. And I'm like, I'm at every Gary Patterson press conference. I haven't heard him say that once. I don't know where the UT people are getting this information from, or they're just trying to make noise up because that's kind of what they do. This is a team that's built for, they have a lot of speed and some questions at quarterback. So what do you do with that? Typically short passes. You do a lot of screens. You keep the ball within the first 10 yards. I don't want Tay Barber having an average reception of 9 yards. If you keep it short, you can complete a lot of high percentage passes, maybe make a guy miss, and we're off to the races. So I can see that being a factor this year for TCU. You have a lot of speed. You have a couple guys that can burn everyone deep down the field. You just need someone else to be more reliant versus just relying on Jalen Reagor like they did last season. But again, if you have confident quarterback play, now say we don't necessarily think Alex Delton's got the greatest arm in the world, but he's a guy that can complete passes. And don't make him do too much. Make him just throw shorter passes. I go back to Kenny Hill in 2017, I think it was, where they just dumbed down the offense way down. Threw a bunch of short passes. His completion percentage was up like 70%, 75%. Didn't take a whole lot of risk, and they ended up winning the Alamo Bowl against Stanford because him and a couple big plays with Jalen Reagor. So I think that's kind of your MO for this year is keep the ball short, throw short passes, take care of the football. Last year, the first 5 weeks, they were like negative 12 in turnover margin. Then the last 3 weeks, they were plus 8 or whatever to end up winning, like obviously winning the Cheez-It Bowl, but getting bowl eligible, which was in question most of the year last year for losing to Kansas. So take care of the ball. Don't make a bunch of dumb mistakes. Keep the ball short. Get in the hands of your playmakers and short passes. Make somebody miss.